आय एम आभा निनेत अभ्यंकर अहिल्या देवी हायस्कूल पुणे. आय एम वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टंट टीचर. फ्रेंड्स, नाव यू आर इन 10th स्टैंडर्ड. सो टुडे वी आर बिगिनिंग विथ यूनिट 1, यूनिट 1.1 ऑफ टीनेजर्स प्रेयर. फ्रेंड्स, यू आर इन 10th स्टैंडर्ड नाव एंड वेरी सून आफ्टर यूर ग्रेजुएशन यू आर गोइंग टू एंटर इन अ ह्यूज open world. This is a very crucial phase of our life because we have to take some important decisions in this phase. A decision about our career and decision about our life. What we want to be and how we are going to achieve your goals. So friends, in this phase there are some worries, doubts and questions in our mind becomes very, very unstable. To take a decision, our mind must be stable one. Here, a prayer can help us. Because whenever we pray, our mind is filled with peace, with positive vibes, and our mind becomes very stable. So, friends, as you know that there is a custom, whatever we want to begin, any new task or our day or any auspicious function, we begin it with the prayer. First, we pray the God, take His blessings, and then only we start our activity. So here also, as you are entering into a very crucial and important phase of your life, let's pray the God, take His blessings, and then begin. This is a poem by J. Morse, a prayer of a teenager. Let's see what the poet tells us. A Teenager's Prayer by J. Morse. J. Morse is a poet who is master in expressing a large message in very simple and few and sweet words. As we are going to see a teenager's prayer, let's first understand what a teenage is. What is a teenage? An age group which lies between 13 to 19 years is a teenage. Teenage is a period of our life where you are neither a child or nor an adult. Let's see about the poem. The speaker of the poem is a teenager like you. Teenage years are very critical years of our life because in our body and in our brain, many changes are being taken. In these years, we have to make some important decisions of our life and of our career. Which stream we should use, we should take, and how we are going to achieve our goal. What we expect from the life and how we are going to get it. So we have to plan. Sometimes we are not able to understand what is right and what is wrong. That's why somebody must be there to guide us. Somebody must be there with us to give some guidelines, some advice that will make our life very comfortable and successful. When we decide to take any decision, we have to think many a times because a right decision can make our life happy and successful. A wrong decision can make our life unhappy and miserable. So, we have to think many a times which stream I should use, which stream I want to be in this to make my life. A teenager wants to live a happy and successful life. Actually, everybody wants to live a happy and successful life. But for that, we have to take some efforts. So, there must be someone to guide us. So, a teenager is praying to God to help him, to guide him, and to be with him in his teenage years so that he can live a successful life ahead. Friends, when somebody is there with us, we feel very comfortable. If somebody is there to guide us, we feel comfortable. And if we feel that somebody is watching us, then of course our behavior is changed positively. So here a teenager is praying the God to help him and to be with him in his teenage years. Let's see the poem. First, we will read the first stanza. Each day brings new beginnings, decisions I must make. I am the only one to choose the road that I will take. Here, make and take are rhyming words. Each day brings new beginnings. So, as we start our day, every day is very new for us. But in the teenager's angle, we can see that every day starts with new beginnings. Here, the poet expresses that new beginnings means new challenges or new tasks or new idea. So, when we are growing up, you have to face new challenges and new tasks and new ideas. Of course, we learn many new things here. I have to make my decisions on my own because it is my life and I have to choose the road of my life. Friends, whenever we say that this is my life, automatically the responsibility is on own shoulders. So, to handle this responsibility very correctly, he says that the God should be with him. So, each day in this way, each day brings new beginnings and he has to take decision of his own life. So, the poet says, I am the only one to choose the road that I will take. The road, which one he should take, he must be the responsible person. So, he has to take and he has to choose the road. The decision is completely of the teenager. I can choose to take the road of life that leads to great success or travel down the darkened road that leads to great distress. Here we can see that there is a teenager and there are two roads. First road is a road which is an opening of new challenges which are leading him to great success. And second one is road to great distress. So he has to choose. I can choose to take the road of life. Here the poet wants to say that the road of life means our lifespan. The road of life means our lifespan. So which road shall I choose which will lead me to great success? So here is somewhat fear, or the poet has a worry in his mind. You can see same reflection of your emotions and your thoughts here. So he asks, I can choose to take the road of life that leads to great success, or the road which I chose will lead me to travel down the darkened road that leads to great distress. Which one I have to choose? Of course, the road that will lead to great success, right? So, the road we should choose must be the right one. In this stanza, the teenager says that there will be two roads in front of me. One road leads to great success. Here, the road of success refers to happy, satisfactory, and successful life. And if I, means the teenager, chooses a darkened road, here, darkened road means an evil road which can make his life full of worries and life of miseries. Of course, nobody wants to lead such a life. Here, there are two new words. One is darkened. Here, this word refers to evil or something bad. Second word is distress, means great worry and strain. In this stanza, let's see what the poet says. Please open up my eyes, dear Lord, that I must clearly see. Help me stand for what is right. Bring out the best in me. Here, see and me are rhyming words. In this stanza, the poet is telling the God, requesting the God to open his eyes. Why he says like that? Because in this age, we are not a child, but not an adult also. So sometimes we cannot understand what is right and what is wrong. So if we do something wrong, we have to suffer. That's why the poet requests the God that please open my eyes to see clearly what is wrong and what is right and the reality of soul. Please open up my eyes, dear Lord, that I might clearly see. Help me stand for what is right. Bring out the best in me. And of course, he's requesting the God that help me stand for what is right. And friends, sometimes there is a battle between our brain and between our heart. Our heart says something, but our brain says something else. So, to fight this battle and win, we should always stand for what is right. So, here the poet is asking and requesting the God that he should be with him to stand for, to have a courage, to stand for what is right. And he further, he requests that bring out the best in me. So, as each day is beginning with new challenges or new tasks, we have to face many new things. So, which things which we have not experienced yet. So, we don't know some positive sides of our personality also. But whenever we face some challenge and win, then only we can understand that, yes, I have that ability. So, he requests the God that he should be there with him and he should bring out the best in me. So the God should give the strength and toughness enough to bring out the best in him, that he should face the challenge and the God should give him the power or strength to face that challenges. In this stanza, the teenager requests God to open up his eyes so that he can see everything very clearly. Here it means that he should be able to see what is right and what is wrong for him. God should help him to stand for right things. The teenager wants to bring out the best things in him, and for that he needs help from the God. Help, Lord, just say no when temptation comes my way, that I might keep my body clean and fit for life each day. Here, way and day, these words are rhyming words. In this stanza, the poet says that the God should help him to say no. Sometimes there are some situations in which we can't say no. Actually, we know that whatever is going on is not good or it's wrong. But still, maybe the outer forces make us to go for that things. In this situation, the poet wants the power or toughness or strength and courage to say no. So he requests the God that the God should help him to say no. When temptation comes my way, what I might keep my body clean and fit for life each day. What is a temptation? Temptation is a strong wish to do something bad or wrong. We are living in a world which have, the world is full of temptations. Here we can see temptation of chatting on mobiles, watching TV for a long time, or chatting on social media, using social media, or crave for food, especially craving for fast food or hoteling. These are some temptations. Of course, fashion and styles also temptation. Excess of anything is an addiction. So, if we want to lead a good life also, we have to say no to such bad habits, because these habits are distracting us. So, here the poet wants the God, that the God should give him the strength to say no. So, please develop good habits, healthy habits of food, which will be beneficial for your health, our body, and of course for our mind also. Then only we can lead a good life. Exercising, keeping good company of friends, reading good books can be some good habits which will keep away from such temptations and will help us to lead a very good life. In this stanza, a teenager requests God to give him strength to say no to all the temptations that will come in his way. Further, the teenager says that if he can keep himself away from all the bad desires and wishes, he can live a happy life. His body and mind will be clean. Why it will be clean? Because if he has done nothing wrong, then he doesn't have to repent. So his body and mind will be clean. Here it means that the bad thoughts will not affect his mind and soul. I can keep myself mentally and physically fit and strong. When my teenage years are over, I know that I will see that life is lived it very best with you walking next to me. Here, see and me are rhyming words. Here, the poet says that if the God is with him, then he will do right things. And of course, as he is doing right things only, when his teenage years are over, he will see himself as a best one, a best human being, because his life will be lived at its very best form. So, in this last stanza, the teenager says that when his teenage years are over, he has chosen the right path and made the correct decisions, and so he had lived his best life, his life in the best manner. In the last two lines, the teenager thanks the God for being with him and supporting him in taking important decisions of his life. So, you should always be grateful to the God or whatever you have done, because there is someone to support you, then only we can lead a good life. So, in the last two lines, the poet is paying his gratitude to the God, that he will definitely know that something which is happening good is only because the God is with him. So, as the teenager knows that the God is walking next to him, he could do all the good things. That's why we must be grateful also. Let's see summary of the poem. The poem is in the form of a prayer by a teenager. In this poem, a teenager prays to God to show the right path, means right direction in life. Teenage is very critical period of life. The teenager wants to live a happy and successful life. He prays to God to make him strong and firm enough to avoid temptations. He knows the choice that he makes at this point of life will decide whether the future is going to be happy or distressed. After the teenage years are over, he will be satisfied that he had lived the best teenage life just because the God was constantly with him. Let's see how to write appreciation of the poem. In third section of our activity sheet, we have to write appreciation of the poem. For that, we have to remember title of the poem, name of the poet or poetess, rhyming scheme of the poem, figures of speech and central idea, your favorite lines also you have to remember. So, let's see. Title, A Teenager's Prayer, poet is J. Morse. Rhyme scheme of this poem is A, B, C, B. Figure of speech, please open up my eyes, dear Lord. This line is directly addressed to God, which is an abstract concept. So, apostrophe, figure of speech is used here. Let's see the central idea or theme of this poem. This poem is in a form of a prayer of a teenager who wants to live a happy and successful life. He requests God to help him to take proper decisions of life in his teenage and to give strength to keep himself away from all the temptations. What is figure of speech? Figure of speech is a special feature used in language to bring a special effect, to beautify the language. It increases the beauty of language. It is also called as figurative language. So whenever if we use figure of speech, our language becomes very beautiful and effective also. Why should we use figure of speech? It is a figurative language. Figurative language creates a picture in our mind. It helps to understand the message and brings special effect. It helps us to understand the message quickly and effectively. Of course, it increases the beauty of the language. Figure of speech helps to understand the concept quickly, effectively, clearly, and easily. So, whenever it is possible for us, we should use figurative language, means figure of speech. Apostrophe. This is a figure of speech. Let's see something about it. An apostrophe is a direct address to the dead, to the absent, or an abstract idea or thing or an object. In poetry, very often there are lines in which the poet seems to talk directly to an absent person or an abstract idea or thing or object. In this, we talk directly with a person or object or an idea which is abstract, lifeless, or dead, assuming they are in front of us. As in this poem, we can see that many a times, O Lord, O God, the words are there. So, in this way, we can feel that the poet is constantly talking with the God, means having connection with the God. So, actually the God is not present there because God is an abstract idea, but still there is a contact between our poet and the God, and it beautifies the poem also. Let's see some examples of apostrophe. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. This is very well known poem. Here, twinkle, twinkle, little star. So, as if the poet of this poem is talking to the stars, which are very little. Here, star is a lifeless object, but still, the poet is talking to the star. Second one, dear God, please save this world. Here, God is abstract. Third example, let's see. Oh friend, I wish you were here. Actually, in this sentence, we can feel that friend is absent, but still, whoever the speaker is contacting or is telling something directly to his friend. "Okay, man, I wish I could live with you." Here, caveman is no more. Alliteration. Alliteration is very common figure of speech. Alliteration is the occurrence of the same sound in a phrase or sentence, etc. Same sound is repeated. We should remember that later is not important, but sound of later should be same. Let's see some examples. "That life is lived it very best." Here, sound of letter L is repeated. "Travel down the darkened road." Here, sound of D is repeated. "My granny tells fairy tales." Here, sound of letter T is repeated. "Peter enjoys physics lesson." In this sentence, P letter is repeated, but the sound is different, Peter and physics. So, it is not an example of alliteration. "Chess and carom are indoor games." In this sentence, C letter is repeated, but the sound is different, chess and carom. So, it is not an example of alliteration. So, in this way, we have to remember that sound is important, not the occurrence of letters. Now, choose the correct alternative. The speaker of the poem is, of course, teenager. The teenager is talking to teacher or God. God. The teenager wants to stand with right or wrong. Right. The teenager wants to choose the road of life that leads toward success. The teenager wants to find the dash in him, God or best. The correct option is best in him. Now we have to find the pair of rhyming word from the poem. Tech, make, success, distress, me, see. Best of luck, friends, to choose a right road. And I am very sure you will definitely choose. So friends, please read this poem twice and write appreciation of this poem. Thank you. Thank you.